just me, just Dre. And we got Casual Geographic. My mind just straight blank, son. Casual Geographic, the wolf who would be king. What the f- bro, I can't think straight right now. What is up? I think I'm just hungry, bro. Let's get it. Boys, we out here to learn and laugh at the same time. Let's get it. I mean, we just getting straight to the fucking point. I don't have to burp, never mind. I thought I was gonna burp.
So we've talked about animals that have beef, but these animals have a whole three-way situation going on. So you might know that ravens and wolves have a business arrangement where ravens will lead them to food, whether it's fresh kills or prey, and in return, the ravens get to eat the wolves' leftovers. Not only that, but it seems like the ravens will also form relationships with individual wolves in a pack and will even be seen playing with wolf pups. And that's where the coyotes come in. Coyotes are opportunists that can hunt, but they'll also try to score a free meal whenever they get the chance. Wolves hate coyotes because they'll steal their kills and will even delete any unprotected wolf pups. Coyotes hate wolves because wolves are everything they are but better in every way, and wolves will often murk them on sight. In rare cases, coyotes will attempt to harass and bully lone, injured, or old wolves. Ravens don't mess with coyotes because they're competition. So here's what happens. Coyotes will often attempt to finesse some of the wolves' kill when they're not looking, which can result in ravens basically calling for a hit on them by making these loud alarm calls. These alarm calls get the attention of the wolves, who will then attempt to chase the coyote.
Damn, off. Y'all some snitches.
Sometimes
too.
Sometimes they won't stop at just chasing. You're looking at about 5 wolves and 1 less coyote. And
Damn.
Someone in the desert roadrunner smoking a wily pack. And since ravens are scavengers, they get to eat what's left of the now life-canceled coyote. So basically, the ravens will snitch on the coyotes to their big brother wolves. And if you know about ravens, they're 100% smart enough to do that. But keep in mind, coyotes will sometimes put ravens on a meal prep too. Moral of this video,
Should've been doing that. Nature really hates
coyotes. Wolves and ravens aren't the only ones to work out an arrangement like that. Coyotes and badgers have every reason to hate each other, with coyotes sometimes turning on badgers and badgers occasionally flatlining coyote pups. But they'll put aside their differences because between a coyote's speed and a badger's burrowing, they make life infinitely more difficult for prairie dogs when they hunt together. Tarantulas will adopt humming frogs to protect their eggs from insects, and in return the tarantula protects the frog from the rest of the world. Even ants have allies. You see, ants and acacia trees have a business arrangement where the ants live inside the thorns of the acacia. The ants pay rent by attacking anything that attempts to eat from the acacia, and that can include other insects like crickets all the way to herbivores like giraffes and even elephants.
Damn!
And this partnership starts when the acacia produces a smell that attracts a queen ant, the same way the smell of pie causes a cartoon character to defy gravity. And these ants aren't pushovers. If an animal like a giraffe threatens their home, then they'll swarm out and mass sting to the point where they can fend off animals millions of times their size. Like I said, ants are about that action, and if they were the same size as humans, they would end the entire world in one weekend.
Period.
The ants'
underground kingdom
lets you see exactly what a motivated ant colony is capable of. It's a simulation strategy game that's gained over 35 million players worldwide in just its first year. That's almost an entire Canada. And this game lets you experience life as an ant in a natural world by pretty much having you do as real ants do. You can hatch and develop your own ant army, including a class of special ants with special abilities. You're free to design and explore ant nests for your ant militia to live in. And when you're not doing that, you can run phase with lizards, frogs, scorpions, and more, while also joining forces and squatting up with allies like the mantis. You can rally your ants into battle through PvP, alliance battles, and even crossover battles with players from all around the world. It was awarded the best game changer in 2021, not because of its stunning graphics or enticing battles, but because this game has wrecked my sleep and work schedule more than once. So to play the world's first ant simulation strategy mobile game, download the Ants Underground Kingdom using the link in the description and use my code to get more fun little surprises. Unless you're a YouTuber who has to make a video promoting it, because apparently playing this game until the birds wake up isn't a valid excuse for that video being 2 days late. And with the special summer carnival coming, there is no better time to download other than yesterday. Have you ever heard the story of the Druid Pack? If not, pause this video, get you some food, get comfortable, because this is a whole movie. The Druids were a famous wolf pack that pretty much dominated over in Yellowstone. At one point, the pack was 37 wolves strong, and yeah, that's a lot of wolves. At the time, it was one of the largest wolf packs ever recorded. The Druid pack were the rulers of Lamar Valley in Yellowstone, which was one of the most valuable hunting grounds in the entire area. Thanks to thousands of elk that would pass through Lamar each year, and as a top pack, the Druids got full control of all that real estate. There was also a coyote couple that would scavenge the wolves' leftovers, and the wolves for the most part would tolerate them as long as they weren't too pressed for food. Remember them, they're gonna be important later. So for years, the Druid pack would live comfortably off the elk they'd catch as the dominant predators in Lamar Valley. But in life, and especially in the wild, one thing is definitely true. Nothing worth having is easy to keep. Remember when I said there was 37 of them at one point? Well, 2 years later, the Druid pack got hit with a severe disease that did a number on them, severely weakening the adults and even murking some of the pups. But everything changed when the Slough Pack attacked. The Sloughs were their rivals, named after the Slough Creek where they originated from. And as the Druids lost members and got weakened by disease, the Sloughs slowly but surely started moving onto their home territory. That escalated to the point where one of the adult female Druids got jumped and turned into a chalk outline by some Sloughs. Later on, another female got erased, and after a winter where no pups survived, the once dominant Druid pack suffered severe layoffs. The pack that once boasted 37 members got cut down to just 4. One of them was a young black male who had only recently joined the pack. He was a lover who made moves on all the females in the pack while also being submissive to all the males. Since he was clearly more of a lover than a fighter, researchers nicknamed him Casanova. Don't forget him, he's going to be important later. At this point, they were clearly outnumbered, and after nearly getting turned into past tense by the Sloughs, what was left of the Druids basically got evicted from Lamar Valley, and they were forced to move to an area known as Cache Creek, leaving the Wolves from Slough Creek as a new top pack in the valley.
Hey, now, man.
Remember that coyote couple Gang I told violence. You about? What I didn't tell you is that they were actually expecting pups in the spring. And with groceries low with pups on the way, that's probably why the father ended up doing what he did next. Viewer discretion warning, this might hurt your feelings. Now remember how I also said the Druids would somewhat tolerate the coyote scavenging? Yeah, the Sloughs were not about to let that slide.
Nah.
When the father coyote tried picking off their food as usual, the new landlords wasted no time and jumped him. The Slough pack chased him down and proceeded to maul him into a hashtag all while his pregnant mate could only watch from a distance. With the Sloughs being very much anti-coyote, the now single mother had no choice but to abandon the valley and find a new place to have her pups. Because having them in the valley with the Sloughs in charge would just be abortion with extra steps. But don't worry, this isn't the last we see her. But yeah, with no Druids or coyotes, the Sloughs were now fully in charge of Lamar Valley. But like I said, nothing worth having is easy to keep. An unknown disease believed to be either parvo or distemper rocked the Slough Creek pack and rocked them hard. Like to the point where out of like 15 pups, I think only like 3 lived. And it wouldn't help when the Sloughs would soon get a taste of their own medicine when they were attacked by another pack.
Yeah.
Not only did this mysterious pack delete some of the Sloughs, they actively kept them from feeding their pups by blocking them from the den. As a result of that and the virus, none of the Slough pups made it. And with the Sloughs' numbers dropping the way it was gas prices would, they had no choice but to retreat back to their original territory. And with no wolves in the valley, guess who stepped up? For a short while, coyotes actually became the dominant predators in the valley with no wolves to check them. Speaking of coyotes, remember that pregnant mother coyote who watched her partner die in front of her before getting run out the valley herself? Well, that story actually has a happy ending. She actually ended up successfully raising all 3 of her pups after she was evicted from the valley.
That's
and
good.
She did it as a single mother. But whatever happened to the Druid pack?
Well, remember Casanova, mothers.
The flirt of the group? While in exile, Casanova actually helped rebuild the pack with some of the daughters. Like I said, bro was a lover. And since they were forced out the valley, that means they didn't get hit with the same disease that rocked the Sloughs. With the Druids strong again and the Sloughs now hanging by a thread, the Druids returned to take back the valley
by
Casanova. Battered and beaten, the Sloughs didn't even put up a fight, they just left. Allowing it to all come full circle as the Druid pack reclaimed the valley they had
Came
lost.
Came back on that ass.
With the help of newcomer Casanova. So long story short, Lion King with wolves. Long live the Druids. I went to a wolf farm this weekend, so naturally here's some facts about wolves. They're born with blue eyes and become some shade of yellow after a couple months. Wolves are born blind and deaf and are Helen Keller to the world around them for the first 2 weeks. There is no such thing as an alpha wolf, since a wolf pack is really just 2 mating wolves and a couple generations of their children. And despite what we used to think, the older siblings will actually look after and defend the babies of the pack. Here you got a father wolf and a couple of his oldest children distracting a black bear and leading it away from a den to protect the pups inside. Since more pups means more mouths to feed, the parents will actively knock block their own children to keep their babies from making more babies. Wolves will howl to mark their territory, but they can also change the pitch of their howl to make it sound like there's more of them than there really are. This way, 2 or 3 wolves can really sound like 10, which can scare off a predator or another pack.
Your niggas is nice.
This is Thor. I like Thor. When resources are high, wolf packs will sometimes temporarily join together. In 2011, a super pack of 400 wolves ran through Russia and allegedly murked 30 horses in only 4 days. There's never been a case of a healthy wolf murking a human in North America. Like, ever. You're more likely to get crossed off the census by a squirrel. Also, I went to Howling Wolves Farm in New Jersey. No
a
sponsor,
fucking
I just
squirrel.
Love them that much. Oh yeah, koi wolves are a thing. They're taking over, and that could be a problem. Now, normally coyotes and wolves hate each other with every kind of prejudice. But with the wolf population nearly getting put into gulag by a certain hairless primate, some wolves decided that a coyote was their last option. To be fair, weirder things have happened. Just ask the roller bears. This wolf-coyote collab resulted in a candid with both parents' DNA. Which is why we now have koi wolves. And most koi wolves have some dog in them, and that I can't even explain. Now here's why it could be a problem. Wolves are fluffy tanks, but they're naturally afraid of people. Coyotes are born giving less of a but they're not really big enough to really be a threat, unless you're like somebody's cat. Mixing them together is like playing Jurassic Park with puppies. So what you have now is an animal that isn't as afraid of people as wolves and can live around people, while also being bigger than a normal coyote. To be fair, they're not really that dangerous to people and would still rather avoid you than fight you. Your pets are a different story with a worse ending. But in their defense, the only reason they exist is because we drained the wolves' dating pool to the point where they had to start piping coyotes. One thing about nature, she bites back.
People
don't
suck.
Act like you didn't hear me. Yes, grizzly bears are real, they're coming, they might just be getting started. And
yeah, that's
exactly
shit.
What it sounds like. Grizzlies and polar bears piping each other and producing a grizzly bear. Or a pizzly.
Grizzlies and polar
bears. Basically, if the father's a grizzly bear and the mother's a polar bear, then you'd call the cub a grizzly bear. But if the daddy's a polar bear, then you'd call it a pizzly. And just like with the coy wolf in America, this one's on us too. Basically, as temperatures keep rising, grizzly bears keep wandering further up north. At the same time, polar bears have to travel further south for groceries since the sea ice they depend on to hunt seals is becoming just sea. So as the two bears end up in each other's area codes, the more they collab and create these hybrids. Now this hybrid is usually bigger than a grizzly, but smaller than a polar bear. And despite being a hybrid, it seems these mixed bears act more like polar bears. Yeah, that might not be a good thing. Now normally grizzlies and polar bears are on sight with each other, like to the point where one might attempt to eat the other. But just like how coyotes and wolves hooked up and created a coy wolf, again because of us, grizzlies and polar bears might end up making a whole new bear. We effed around and now we finna find out. We've all had this question at one point, and if you say you haven't, you're a liar.
He's
that question
fuck,
being, if we weren't here, what animal would run the world? You know what? This might be a hot take, but I really think we are one Thanos snap away from seeing crows in a driver's seat. Crows, ravens, corvids in general, they're all too smart for anyone else's good, and one day they're gonna turn on us, and it's gonna be bad. I'm not gonna talk about the fact that ravens are low-key domesticating wolves the same way we did. Or that crows have the intelligence and a problem-solving ability of a 7-year-old. And you probably already know that crows are smart enough to drop nuts
ain't
on
no
crosswalks
fucking
paws,
way.
Let a car run over it, and then wait for the walk sign to go claim their prize. Not only are crows smart enough to use tools, some scientists say the Caledonian crow has entered its own stone age. And while crows can't recognize their own reflection, they do understand how mirrors work. Basically, in an experiment, crows were able to find an object not in their direct line of sight by using its reflection in a nearby mirror. Not only can crows and ravens remember faces for years, but they'll go on to teach their kids not to mess with you. Both ravens and crows can hold grudges, especially if they feel like they've been wronged. When a crow sees another dead crow, it'll call out to its other crow bros and they'll investigate the cause of its death to make sure the area is still safe for them. They're even smart enough to have self-control. In another experiment, crows were willing to deny a piece of food if doing so meant they got a bigger reward down the line. And I'm just realizing this, but that also means crows and ravens can plan for the future. Yeah, that's not normal. And we've already seen what happens when crows turn on people. Crows in Tokyo have gotten bold enough to straight up attack people for food, for territory, or just for the sport of it. They'll even go as far as to purposely take aim and drop deuces on people. Those same Tokyo crows have memorized the garbage schedules of different parts of the city, so when crows pull up, it's not by accident. There's a reason why Rick chose crows. One day we're gonna get real life Hitchcocked and it's not gonna be good. I just realized something kind of interesting.
Holy
we
shit,
all know
man.
Can talk. It's not exactly groundbreaking.
Crows?
But way less people know that ravens can do the exact same thing and probably do it better. Like other corvids, ravens can mimic a bunch of sounds, including human speech, and are more likely to do it when they're in constant close contact with people. You don't even need to listen to me talk, just listen to the raven.
The ravens are excellent at mimicking sounds they hear. Mischief, can you say hello?
Hello.
Good. He does all sorts of voices.
Hi.
Good job.
That's actually kind of cute, even though you bitches are fucking scaring the shit out of me now.
What's up? Not much.
What's up?
Who's your good bird?
Watch out.
Alright, you alright?
You alright?
I'm alright.
You alright?
Nah, fuck this shit.
I wonder how many people got put in mental hospitals because nobody would believe the voices in their heads were actually a bird. Matter of fact, at one point, that'll probably get you a lobotomy.
Fuck no. No. No, 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 no. Okay. Fucking crows, man. Yo. I didn't believe it, but now I do. We might get fucking overran by crows, bruh. Crows, bruh. Fucking crows. If you like the video, like, comment, subscribe. Appreciate you for watching. Peace. Crows, bruh. Fucking birds, man.